optimize outcome in tricky situations. The first case is a typical complication of PC rent with cortex behind IOL floating in anterior vitreous, vitreous in AC, single piece IOL which the previous surgeon has somehow managed to put in the sulcus through a 6mm tunnel. The game plan seems pretty simple. Remove cortex by anterior vitrectomy, preferably by pars plana approach, remove vitreous from AC, replace one piece with a 3-piece IOL through the already made scleral tunnel. Open and shut case, what is so out of the box? I began with making a single pars plana port to clear some prolapsing vitreous from behind, making sweeping movements to push back vitreous strands causing pupillary peaking, put viscoelastic to form chamber. From the look of this, I realized that there may not be a PC rent at all, but a folded capsular bag with 3 to 4 clock hour subluxation with cortex still contained in the bag rather than anterior vitreous. I can actually achieve normalcy by inflating the bag and repositioning the IOL inside it rather than explanting it or leaving it in the sulcus itself, for sooner or later it will decenter and get dislocated through the ZD. The challenge was to open out the bag without disturbing the IOL much. Gently lifting the IOL and inflating the bag with viscoelastic, I could manage to insert a capsular tension ring from under the IOL using intravitreal forceps to maneuver the CTRN bag. I then removed the cortex from behind the partially prolapsed IOL, slowly and gently taking care not to rupture the PC, at the same time aspirate the vitreous prolapsing from zonules while intermittent cutting from under the IOL, keeping the cutter side up always. I then guided the IOL back in the bag one haptic after the other. The haptics were rotated in the direction of maximum subluxation, cleaning up the remaining cortex and vitreous and removing the pars plana port. I corrected the pupillary peaking by Sinsky hook sweeps, followed by final cutting of the vitreous strands going to the wound. Should I have stopped at this? I could, but I decided to do a total pars plana vitrectomy despite being sure there won't be any lens matter in vitreous, as lens matter had never left the bag. The vitreous was clean, no doubt. But note the evolution of retinal tear right in front of your own eyes as a result of vitreous tug in a partially PVD'd eye. This would have definitely resulted in a retinal detachment later. It is better to address these potential traction areas, do a thorough base shaving and barrage laser. Moral of the story, always think on the spur of the moment. It's good to plan, but don't go with a fixity of plan. The next example is a case of surgical aphakia with vitreous in AC. Will just anterior vitrectomy with IOL implant suffice? Even though one may do anterior vitrectomy thoroughly with tricot staining, multiple sweeping movements of Sinsky hook, cutting every strand of the vitreous in AC again and again, even lifting the iris skirt to clear vitreous and lens matter under the iris, one should not stop just at that. However, one needn't make pars plana port like in the previous example. Limbal approach is sufficient, making limbal entries for AC maintainer providing infusion, light pipe through the side port and cutter through the side port. Putting on the biome, one needs to clear away any residual lens matter in the posterior vitreous and more importantly, as much vitreous as possible to prevent future PVD-induced retinal breaks. One can also inspect the entire peripheral retina in the process. The advantage of the limbal entry is that they can be done under topical anesthesia, and with slight learning curve, this extended portless posterior vitrectomy can be mastered even by anterior segment surgeons. When putting iris claw in such a case with pars plana port, one faces a lot of turbulence and sealing pars plana port with air becomes difficult as air can go above and below iris claw, destabilizing it. A better technique is to use intravitreal forceps to hold the iris claw through one limbal side entry and tucking with a Sinsky hook through the other, the same entries that were used for extended posterior vitrectomy. This obviates the need for air exchange and the procedure can be performed under topical anesthesia with much better chamber stability as the main wound remains closed. Final example is implantation of a unique lens called Swiss Fold. After creating sclerotomies under scleral flap, the single piece hydrophilic foldable lens is injected through a 2.8 mm incision and the haptics are externalized through the scleral flaps. This IOL, unlike other SF IOLs, does not need tucking or suturing of haptics. Unlike iris claw lenses, it does not need any enclavation, can be implanted even if there is some iris tissue loss or atrophy, and does not affect pupillary dilatation. Overall, the procedure is much easier, less time consuming, with minimal tissue handling and therefore better post-operative results. No glue.